Right there, AP 124. I'm sorry, book one, lines 124 to 156. Here we go. Meanwhile, Neptune, gravely upset, deeply pissed off, noticed that the sea was being tossed about with a great rumbling, that a storm, which was sent forth, and that the waters, which had previously been still, were pouring back onto the depths of the sea. So he's like, wait a minute, I didn't order this. And looking out over the deep sea, he raised his peaceful head from the top of the water. So I want you to think of it like this. Okay, like that. That could have gone badly. He sees the fleet of Aeneas scattered throughout the entire sea. The Trojans overcome by waves and by the downpour of the heavens. And he the tricks of Juno didn't escape him. He didn't miss them. Didn't escape the notice of her brother. He calls to the east and west winds to himself. And when they get there, he says these things, or says such things. Is there so great a arrogance, a confidence in your origin? Did it hold you? In other words, you forget who you are? Do you dare now, O winds, stir up heaven and earth without my divine power? And do you dare to raise such large masses? And I always wondered if that was like masses of water or masses of power or masses of confusion. I don't know. Masses of plot devices. And he's still talking to them. So y'all, whom I... And then he totally like stops. And I'm a dad. I've done this. Where you're like, dah, dah, dah. You know what? Let's go do this. So that's what he's saying. He's like, it is better to compose the waves which have been disturbed. Afterwards, you will atone for your injuries or your crimes to me with a not similar punishment. So I'm calming the wind or the waves. We're going to talk when you get home. Now, hurry. Flee from here and say these things to your king, that it was not given to him by lot the right to rule the sea and this cruel trident, but it was given to me. He holds huge rocks. He's talking about Aeolus, which are your home, east wind. Let Aeolus toss himself about in that prison, or in that hall, and let him rule after the winds have been shut back in their prison. Thus he speaks. And quicker than a word, he calms the swollen seas, and he puts the gathered clouds to flight. He scatters them. And he brings back the sun. Do-do-do-do. Together, Kaimotoe and Triton. I believe there's a note there about them. Oh, it says see line 325. So let me go to 325 for you. See, this book is the entire Aeneid, and I don't remember if you guys have to do 325 or not. So 325. It's not there. All right. So together, Kaimothoe and Triton. What do they do? Pushing. They loosen the ships from the sharp rocks, and he himself, Neptune, raises those ships with his trident. So he scoops under, it's like a spatula, right? And uncovers huge sandbars, and he calms the sea, and then he, I like this imagery, he glides along the tops of the waves with swift wheels, because he's got a chariot, right? And just as when, as often as happens, a riot has begun in a huge population, and again, everything Vergil's writing about is absolutely about Rome. And the common crowd rages in their spirit. And they let loose with torches and rocks to fly. And madness supplies their weapons. If by chance they catch sight, the crowd catches sight of any man who is serious in his devotion and service, they fall silent and they stand with their ears pricked up or raised. And he, the man who's so chill, rules their minds with his words and he soothes their hearts. So Neptune basically did the same thing, right? Thus, Neptune caused the entire uproar of the sea to calm down. And after the father, looking out over the seas and carrying things into the open skies, he guides his horses and he gives them rein. Giddy up, giddy up. And flying along, he takes off on his obedient chariot. All right. So, that is that. Yeah. All right. So that takes us through 156. Okay. I'm gonna hit the button.